No, I might like to finish this flight around the world. Could fly to Asia tomorrow. Tomorrow evening we could fly to Asia, long flights. Saturday evening to then Sunday morning I could be in Asia. But then I could get back to Copenhagen like Monday or day after. So I need like 3 or 4 days more to do this. So now we're down in 8,000 feet. Now this high resolution ground sensor will start loading like this. So that's a lot of squares of high resolution. So actually it's look like this. I don't know how to keep this on always. I would like the ground sectors look like this always. As you can see much more here, you have more plots of land. But we are 50 kilometers from there, I cannot 51, yes. But you see there's nothing really here. But it looks like you have a kind of, you have no grass, but you have kind of bushes. You have a little bit growing. It's not a desert, but you have something growing. Maybe you can have a goat. You could have goat farming. Goat, they eat like everything. Yes, we have something here. So they split the lane in all these hundreds of thousands of kilometers and tens of thousands of these squares. I think you buy it from like a government or the province, the city council. But you have tens of thousands of these plots, of course, you're not just moving into here, because there's nothing here. No, they don't like this land, they like the farmland up north, close to Buenos Aires, that they want to buy. They're not, but if you have something kind of factories, that's so important. You could buy a lot, big plot of land for some kind of factory. If you're making concrete or bricks or something, you do. Let's look kind of airfields. There's 2 runways, I think it is, small airports for small single engines. Is this kind of homemade airport? 3 runways and one takeaway. Around here. No, that could be the old air horns. No, that's for single engine, like Cessna 172, I think it is. Yes, here we have it. Neuquien Presidente, Perón International Airport. If I have some luck, we have a flight to the international airport. It's only 10 a.m. in the morning. It's like 9:40 a.m. No, I think they are growing wine. That's not the wheat and barley and corn or something. I think that's something much smaller. I think that small wine field up all could be just private gardens. Could be private gardens. They're growing like potatoes and stuff for the family foods, and they grow something extra to sell on the markets. So 3,000 feet. Well, that could be nice. The ground texture was like this always. But outside this city, there's nothing really anything. There's just this stone deserts, a dry stone deserts. So recording like 30 minutes. So we do this two-part videos. But I will search Wikipedia, this Neuquén. I think someone have write about this city, the population and stuff, what they are growing and... It's 1,000 feet. 30 knots. But we have arrived here. Let's change the view. Yes, we have arrived here. Let's have a look. Let's say we have arrived. That's 5 degrees, and the locus time is 9:41, and runway is 2,500 meters, 8,400 feet. Okay, got something, Buenos Aires. No, we have no flight to this international airport, but we have a flight to Rosario. Should we take one of these flights? That's in 30 minutes, so should we look at a little, how much time? Yes, 33 minutes. We can take one of these flights to Rosario or Cordoba. Let's just do Cordoba, that's in 35 minutes. Let's write that down. It's in 35, Rosario. Yes, but we have this river go all the way inside here. And then you have this big lakes, but we've been looking at that. This lake, but I have a lot of water here. This water goes to the mountain. Like here. And another big lake here. Yes, that's water from the snow and ice. They're melting here. And then they run out here to the ocean. But they have some dams for electricity, like here. They are make hydropower station. They've got a lot of water here. But they have a lot of water, and they even have one more river going up from here. So think they have a water hydropower more here. Yes, hydroelectric. They have one there, but there are plenty of water, but they're not growing anything here. You could have a chicken farm or something. And have something here. More to make power maybe. Then they start to make this got big lake here. So they have more electricity. Hydroelectric, so they got lot of water. And there. Yes, but I think that's wine fields. They start to make this small fields. I think they're growing wine. Like red wine. So they have many thousands of small fields. Like this. I think that's wine. That's not corn or wheat or barley. That's too small for that. But that's maybe another city. No, that's same city. But a lot of people are living here. Yes, but I think you need to work hard because you don't have welfare checks in Argentina. If you have no work, I don't think you get $1,000 every month from the government or $2,000. I think they have a pension. If you're old, like 65 or 70, 68 or something, I think you get like maybe $100 every month. Just a little money, so you're not able, so you have too little bit food. But if you're old person, like 70 years old, have no family, you have to pay rent apartments. I don't think you have much left. You can barely pay your bills, electricity and rent. Yes, I have a lot of this, many thousands. I think that's wine. Vino. Yes, but let's take a break. And let's fly to Rosario. Yes, we have arrival in 10 minutes. Then we have departure Rosario in like 40 minutes. So we're going up to 3 p.m. It's 3 p.m. Video splits. So let's do that. Let's put my clock to half an hour, but we are out of time. No. It's but I'm going to... yes, half an hour. I'll be back.